हेलो एंड वेलकम बैक टू अवर न्यू वीडियो क्लास। हाय माय क्यूट क्यूट स्टूडेंट्स, हाय क्लास सेवन। सो एज इन अवर प्रीवियस वीडियो क्लास वी कंप्लीटेड अवर टॉपिक अ टेल ऑफ टू सिटीज। ओके, सो नाउ दिस इज द टाइम टू मूव ऑन टुवर्ड्स अवर नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ अवर लिटरेचर। द नेम ऑफ अवर नेक्स्ट राइम, द नेक्स्ट पोएम इज बैंगल सेलर्स एंड दिस पोएम इज रिटन बाय सरोजिनी नायडू। सो इन दिस पोएम वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट टू यूज imaginary to describe everyday things in a delightful manner. Okay, so let's read about first of all who is the Sarojini Naidu. The Bangle Sailor is written by Sarojini Naidu. About the poem, I want to tell you first of all, written by the prominent Indian poet and politician Sarojini Naidu. Who is the Sarojini Naidu? Sarojini Naidu were a very much famous poet as well as very much famous politician in the Indian context. Okay, so I will have to be read first of all in that particular in manner that the Bangle Sailors is a poem exploring the life of Indian women, the Indian culture and traditions revolving around women. In most of her poems, Sarojini Naidu writes on the theme of Indian culture and people. Her poems are focused on Indian settings and this poem makes no exception. In this Indianness, the poem resembles another poem of hers in the Brazzas, in the bazaars of Hyderabad. So this is the poem which focuses on the Bangle Sailor, and this poem also gives the remembered thought about the bazaars of Hyderabad. The poem revolves around bangles, which is an important ornament for embellishment of women in Indian society. In the poem, the Bangle Sailors are at the temple fair and they shout out to the people passing by to have a look at their bangles. They urge them to buy bangles for their daughters and wives. So as you can see on the screen, there are certain women are there and Bangle Seller is there, and that women are having the bangles bought out for their daughters and their wives. Okay, so now let's see what is exactly into that. The form and language of the poem is considered as to be the poem. The entire poem has a structure where each stanza focuses on a particular theme. Okay, so as you can see on the screen, there are four stanzas and each stanza has focuses on a particular structure, has a particular theme on that, and that theme were focused in every stanza. Okay, so the first stanza depicts that the merchants toting at the temple fair to attract the attention of the people passing by. The consequent stanzas focus on bangles of various colors. The sailor have for women of all different ages. The poem The Bangle Sailors has a simple rhyme scheme of AABBCC. For each stanza, means what is mean by AABBCC? This is the particular scheme of rhyming, means bare, fair, bright, light, lives, wives. Okay, so AABBCC. AA means bare, fair, then BB means what? Bright, light, then CC means lives, wives. Okay, then again wrist, mist, dream, stream, cliffs, leaves, corn, moth, fire, desire, clear, tear, grey, midway, blessed, breast, pride, side. Okay, so this is the particular rhyming scheme of this the Bangle Sailor poem. AABBCC. You have to keep in mind that the particular rhyming scheme of the poem The Bangle Sailor is AABBCC. Okay, this is very simple one. With most octets symbolic lines. The poem has no distinctive meter, but one has an apparition of the same due to the use of easy language and a general fluidity of words. Use of clever similes has made it a beauty. So the particular rhyming scheme was very simple, AABBCC, and the language were also very very easy, and it's just generally fluidically, so the words are very fluidified, and so that there are certain clever similes are also makes the enhancement in the particular stanzas of the poem. So first of all, I will read the first stanza. The first stanza is, Bengal sailors are we who bear our shining loads to the temple fair. Who will buy this delicate bright rainbow tinted circle to light, lustrous tokens of radiant lives for happy daughters and happy wives. Okay, so this is first stanza. What the first stanza says, the poem begins with the speakers introducing themselves as Bengal sailor who sell their articles at the temple fair. Yes, at the temple fair, the Bengal sailor sells his bangles. They call out to the people to buy their bangles. These hawkers describe their bangles as delicate, bright, rainbow-tinted circles of light. They advertise by questioning who will buy these bangles for their daughters and wives. Okay, so this is the first stanza. Then again, it is important to note that here, that though the speakers of the poem are several, it appears as if there is a single speaker. This is due to the fact that they all have the same purpose and are thus seen singularly as a class essence. Also, the bangles here are called lustrous tokens of radiant lives. Yes, as you can see here, lustrous tokens of radiant lives. It shows us the Indianness of the poem, where bangles are bought on special occasions and are associated with happiness and prosperity. Yes, definitely, we only have to buy bangles when we have certain occasion, when we have certain festival. Yes, means for example, Eid, Diwali, Deepavali, Dasera, at this time only, means at the special occasion, the women's, the daughters, the wives will have the bangles. Yes, so this is very much important, we have to note down here. Then next stanza, then second stanza is what, some are meet for a maiden wrist, silver and blue as the mountain mist. Some are flushed like the birds that dream on the tranquil brow of a woodland stream. Some are aglow with the bloom that cleaves to the limpid glory of newborn leaves. So there are rhyming words. What are their rhyming words? Wrist, mist, dream, stream, cleaves, leaves. Okay, AABBCC. This is the rhyming scheme again here. So what is the meaning of this second paragraph? Sorry, this second stanza. The second stanza onward, the speakers talk of the kinds of bangles they have. Some of these bangles are suited for maidens. Yes, they are suited to the maidens. That is a young unmarried woman's wrist. They are silver and blue in color like the mountain mist. Yes, some of them are flushed. That is pink and light red in color, like flower buds growing beside a woodland stream. Yes, then still others are green and glowing like the transparent beauty of newborn leaves. Okay, so this is the meaning of second stanza. We have to again keep in mind that in Indian society, bangles have an important culture and religious place. Okay, so in our Indian society, bangles are very much important because they denote our culture, our religious places. Okay, so different colored bangles are worn by women in different stages of life. Blue, silver and green are generally worn by young maidens. Okay, so which color? Blue color, silver color and green color are generally worn by the young maidens. Okay, young maidens means what we call from 9 year or 10 year girls to the 18 years girls. These are called maiden girls. Okay, so they can worn the particular bangles of having color blue color, silver color and green color. Then it is interesting to note that the poet here uses the word flushed like the birds that stream. Okay, what were that? This, yes, some are flushed like the birds that dream. Okay, so the word birds here is suggestive of chastity. Okay, birds that dreams present before us an imagine of young girl. Okay, young girls dreaming of marriage. In this stanza, the poet presents the stage of youth in a woman's life. Okay, so as the first stanza says, who were the particular person who sells the and how the advertise about his bangles, then second stanza have the theme that the young maidens. Okay, then now our third stanza. What is our third stanza? Some are like fields of sunlit come, meet for a bride on her bridal morn. Some like the flame of her marriage fire, enrich with the hue of her heart's desire, tinkling, luminous, tender and clear, like the bridal laughter and bridal tear. So here again AA, BB, CC is the rhyming scheme. How? Corn, mon, then fire, desire, clear, tear. Okay, so what is the meaning of this stanza? The third stanza have the meaning that in the third stanza, the bangle sellers says that some of their bangles are yellow like field of sunlit corn. Okay, what is the color of the bangle here in the third stanza? The color of the bangle sellers bangle is having the yellow color, and that is like field of sunlit corn. Okay, then bangles of this color are perfect for a bride on her bridal morn. Yes, bride means jise hum dulhan kehte hain. Okay, so this color is perfect for the bride for her bridal morn. Some of the bangles they have are bright red. Yes, some of the have their bright red color. Okay, why? Because they present the flame of a newly turned bride's marriage fire, that is the passion of her newly made relation. Yes, then the red bangles also stand for her heart's desire. The bangles are tinkling, luminous, tender and clear. They express both her joy of starting a new life with her husband and the sorrow of leaving her parents behind. Yes, means when we are going to start our new life, when the bride starts her new life, then it should have the happiness of her husband, but she have again the sorrow of leaving her parents behind. So what we are finding in these lines, what we find striking is the use of words. What is the use of words of streaking? Where is that? Like her bridal laughter and bridal tears. These words convey the whole of a woman's transition in life from a maiden to a wife and all the emotions attached with it in a single line. This stanza marks the transition of life from a maiden to a wife. Okay, so this is the third stanza. Means वो लड़की जब छोटी रहती है, young age की रहती है, तो उसकी एज से वो wife बनने तक की उसकी process यहाँ पे वो bangles बता रहे हैं. Then our last stanza of our poem is, this is our last stanza, the fourth stanza is, some are purple and gold flecked grey, for she who has journeyed through life midway, whose hands have cherished, whose love has blessed and cradled fair sons on her faithful breast, and serves her household in fruitful pride, and worships the gods at her husband's side. Okay, so this is our final stanza, this is our fourth stanza. What is the meaning of the fourth stanza? In the final stanza of the poem The Bangle Sailors, the speakers continue to advise their bangles. They shout that some of their bangles are purple and somewhere are the gold flecked grey. These are suited for a middle-aged woman, okay, for whom that particular bangle suit the color of purple and gold color. The color of purple and gold color of the bangle suits only to the middle-aged woman. Okay, then who has journeyed through life means who the life has been started. They are for her who has raised her children well and has remained faithful to her husband and family. These bangles are, they say, perfect for she who has maintained her household with pride and worships the gods at her husband's side. Okay, in this stanza, what we are going to learn in this stanza? In this stanza, the poet writes down that she perceives as the qualities of a good wife. Such a woman is trusty, deserving of the purple and gold flecked grey bangles in her eyes. Here we should pay attention to the word sons. Okay, which word? The word sons used to mean offspring. Okay, while it could be a happy coincidence, it could also suggest the ingrained attitude of male preference in the society of Sarojini Naidu's times. Okay, then the poem The Bangle Sellers is a celebration of the female life. As you can see here, there are four stanza and every stanza gives a separate theme of the poem, and the poem Bangle Sailors is a celebration of the female life. It shows us the various stages of the woman's life and attempts to represent the Indian culture and the role of Bangle Sailors in the traditional setup. So I think you people now understood this concept, this poem, this theme. Okay, so I think you people understood now. If you have any type of query, you can contact to me. But I think this is very simple one rhyme, this is very simple one poem. And don't forget that this poem has the stanzas four. How many stanzas? Four stanzas. And the rhyming scheme of the poem Bangle Sailor is AA BB CC. AA BB CC. Okay, so in this way we seen our new poem The Bangle Sailor, and in this way we completed that also. If you have any type of query, you can contact to me. I will reply to all your doubts. So in this way we completed our Bangle Sailor poem. In our next video class, we have to go towards our next part, that is the model millionaire. Okay, so thank you so much, dear students. Take care. Good luck. Bye bye. See you in the next video class.